Hello students, welcome for the history. We will be teaching you the book Themes in World History. Okay, so this book is of class 11 and today we are going to do the chapter 1. The name of the chapter is Early Societies. Okay, in this we will be reading about from the beginning of the time, writing and city life. Okay, so we are going to aware you about some important points first. Students, though you are in class 11, start utilizing this period. We cannot wait for your final 10th class result. Okay, moreover, you have to keep on working on your subjects which you feel are interesting and in which you want to make your career. So whatever the stream you will be going to choose, we are most welcome for that. But now for the time of period, what you have to do, we are started uploading the YouTube videos for class 11th. So we are having a common channel in which we will be having all the subjects. So it is up to you, the subject which you are planning to take in your class 11th, you can watch the videos. Okay, moreover, the second is your Snap homework. Please subscribe Snap app and start taking your worksheets from the Snap homework. We will be giving you the PDF of the chapters. Okay, so meanwhile, if the books are not with you, you can focus on the PDFs which we are making you available through Snap app. Is that okay, students? Okay, let's start the topic. Our first chapter is from the beginning of the time. Okay, we will be reading about the beginning of the time. So this is the content which you will be having your own study. I'm not dealing with this. We have to start from this page. Okay, in the basic, I have discussed the timeline, the time period which makes you to understand the history. See, the history students, first concept is to how to study the timeline. In class 11th, every chapter will be having the timeline, which will be giving you the chapter details from this period to this period. The contents the chapter is dealing from this period to this period. Is that okay? So I have discussed about that timeline in your previous schedule, that is the basic class. Okay, so let me read and make you more clear what the chapter of this page tell you. This timeline focuses on the emergence of humans and the domestication of plants and animals. It highlights some major technological developments such as the use of fire, metals, large agriculture, and the wheel. Other processes that are shown include the emergence of cities and the use of writing. You will also find mentions of some of the earliest empires, a theme that will be developed in timeline 2. Okay, in this you can see we will be reading about the 6 million years ago to first BCE, yani before Christ era. Okay, M by A million years ago, BCE before Christ era. I hope you are understanding the topic. Okay, so one more thing you have to understand now. We will be having, every chapter will give you some details of the years. So let's move to the next page. See, students, we are having more clarity with the content. Now there are three columns. Every column is giving you some development in areas. So in the first, you will see the era. The year is changed, and that shows the development in the two continents, Africa and Europe. Correct? So you can study from the dates what has been developed during this date in Africa and Europe. So it make it more clear that 6 million years ago to 5 lakh BP, that is before period, we had some existence of humans in Africa, but nothing is there in Europe. Means we can see the people, the fossils of these peoples have recovered from African continent. Clear? So we have got the evidence of using the fire of 1.4 million years ago. So that evidences were recovered from Africa. Correct? Now, again, if we are moving towards the 5 lakh to 1,50,000 BP period, we can see again the Homo sapien fossils. Homo sapien refers to the men. Okay, that is considered as a modern man. So we can see the evidences in Africa, but that was the period of 1,95,000 BP. Okay, the same period, between the same period, we got the evidences of fire from Europe. So that shows some changes. Now you can see in Africa, the Homo sapien fossils are recovered around 1,95,000 BP. The same it has moved to Europe. Now that Homo sapien fossils we have found around 40,000 BP. So that shows the modern man evidence, means the fossils have been recovered earlier in Africa than in Europe. Okay, I hope you are understanding. Later we have talked about some recovering some evidences sites of caves or the shelters places where these Homo sapiens people lived. We can consider them the modern men. So they had started settling in caves. Okay, we have got the evidence proof from this continent. Again, we are having from another places, that is of Europe, Spain and France, of caves and shelters evidences. Okay, especially they are talking about Spain and France, not any other places of Europe. So day by day we can see the changes. So people, means men, started using animals for their domestication in Africa. Then same, the people later on, these years are increased now, the times are changed. People have moved towards the agriculture. So they have started cultivating wheat and barley. So now you can see the domestication of different animals has been started, and cultivation of different crops have been recovered, means evidences have been recovered. So another side of that is Europe, we can see the use of copper was recovered. So I will not be reading that much. Now you can see the things has changed from year to year. Now we are having ships, means people of Africa has developed that thing early. later on that was changed, that was the, means around 1700 to 1600 around, the people have developed the script in Crete. Okay, so these, you can see the seals, they are having some scripts on them. So that evidences are shown from different continents. Means you can see yearly the progress has been noticed. Okay, the use of iron has been done. Later on, we can find out in around 800 to 700 BCE, we can find the first Olympic Games were organized under Greece. Okay, so these are some of the evidences. Now we can talk about the mode. So people started moving one continent to the another continent. So we can see the origination of Homo sapiens is from Africa continent. On to the second page. The second page is giving the continent of Asia and South Asia. So we can see the evidences of these same 6 million years ago to 5 lakh million years ago. BP. So people of Asia has started using fire. Okay, but at that time in Africa, the people of means we have found the fossils of fire, means evidences of fire we have recovered from Africa. But here also the use of fire was there in China. Okay, the same you can see in South Asia. We have got the sites in Pakistan, that is rival around 19 lakh thousand back, that is BP. Okay, we have got the Homo sapiens fossils here, that is told, that is recovered around 1 lakh BP in West Asia. So that pages are here that go, that tells about what has been recovered in many of these in different continents. Okay, so domestication of animal was seen in Asia around 30,000 to 10,000 BP. Okay, we have got a very famous Bhimbetka cave painting in Madhya Pradesh. So we have talked about this when we have read in Indian history, that is in class 6th. So we have recovered about Homo sapiens fossils in Sri Lanka also. We have talked about the Balochistan, that was a place which is considered as an early agricultural settlement place. Okay, so we can see more discoveries have been shown through this timeline. So that timelines will give you the clear picture of the chapter, that what we are going to read in this two main topics. Now we will be moving to the next content. You have to please go through the deep studies of this. Okay, now our third page is talking about America and Australia, that is the Pacific Islands. So people have their evidences, means Homo sapien. I told again, I'm repeating, Homo sapien is a modern man which is considered from 1,90,000 to 1,60,000 years ago. We consider that sapien, that Homo sapien is considered as a man, means completely they have the brain like a man. So that is considered in America 12,000 BC. We have recovered the paintings from Australia. Less evidences from Australia, but more evidences we have got from Africa, West Asia, and Europe. Okay, we are having less evidences from America and Australia. I hope you understand what I want to make it clear about this. Okay, so by the side, please read the content, what is talking about. So before I start this topic, I'll give you some general information about the years. Students, we are talking about million years ago. Have you ever thought about billion years ago, how the world or how the solar system was? When we talk about the million or billion years ago, we talk about Big Bang Theory. Correct. I am pronouncing Big Bang Theory. That is the theory which is talking about the formation of the solar system. Okay. There was an explosion in which the solar system originated. Yes. This was 13 to 14 billion years ago. Okay, after that, this life means the first life that was seen on the earth around 4 billion years ago. We can say the people got what you will say इंसान का कहीं ना कहीं रूप दिखा. हम उसको इंसान नहीं कहेंगे बट एक जिंदगी कहेंगे, लाइफ कहेंगे. सो द फर्स्ट फॉर्म ऑफ लाइफ वॉज केम ऑन अर्थ अराउंड 4 billion ईयर्स एगो. करेक्ट. सो after that, when we talk about the reptiles and mammals, reptiles around 320 million years ago. Correct. Now we are moving to the millions. Okay, billion stories baat karte hain, Big Bang theory ka, solar system ka, life ka existence show karta hai dharti par. Ab hum baat kar rahe hain life jo फॉर्म चेंज कर रही है अपना, तो वो है रेप्टाइल्स. इफ वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट रेप्टाइल्स, दे आर अराउंड 320 मिलियन ईयर्स एगो. करेक्ट. एंड इफ वी टॉक अबाउट मैमल्स, मैमल्स दे वर अराउंड 200 मिलियन ईयर्स एगो. ओके, जिसमें आप जैसे बातें करते हो डायनासोर्स वगैरह की, तो ये जो कहानियां हैं ये है 200 मिलियन ईयर्स एगो की. आई होप यू आर फाइंडिंग इंटरेस्ट इन हिस्ट्री. ओके, सो व्हेन यू स्टार्ट रीडिंग हिस्ट्री यू शुड नो एटलीस्ट अ लिटिल बैकग्राउंड ऑफ हिस्ट्री आल्सो, कि हम इस चैप्टर में बात करेंगे ह्यूमन एग्जिस्टेंस की, यानी ह्यूमन धरती पर कैसे आया. तो उसी समय हम लोग बात कर रहे हैं वो समय जब हम ह्यूमन एवोल्यूशन तो बात करते हैं कि यानी ह्यूमन आया इस धरती पर, लेकिन उसके रूप क्या क्या थे, वो किस किस रूप में आया. ठीक है, जो फर्स्ट रूप हम लोगों ने डिस्कवर किया है उसको कहते हैं पायरामिड्स, PRIMATES. ओके, द वर्ड्स विल बी कमिंग इन द स्टोरी, बट यू नो एनसीईआरटी को पढ़ना, उसको अंडरस्टैंड करना थोड़ा सा लिटिल डिफिकल्ट होता है जब तक तुम्हें थोड़ा सा बैकवर्ड नॉलेज ना हो, यानी प्रीवियस नॉलेज ना हो. तो उसके लिए आई हैव डिजाइंड दैट लेट मी गिव यू द स्टेजेस ऑफ ह्यूमन इवोल्यूशन. सो दैट इज पायरामिड्स अराउंड 36 to 24 million years एगो. उसके बाद आए थे होमिनॉइड्स, HOMINOIDS, होमिनॉइड्स. होमिनॉइड्स थे अराउंड 24 मिलियन ईयर्स एगो टू 6.4 मिलियन एगो. करेक्ट. तो अब हम बात करते हैं, देखो ये जो वर्ड्स आ रहे हैं, अब हमने यहाँ तक हिस्ट्री कवर किया है अराउंड 6 or 5 मिलियन ईयर्स एगो. तो इसमें दो रूप आते हैं, फर्स्ट वन इज द पायरामिड्स एंड सेकेंड वन इज द होमिनाइड्स. ठीक है, दोनों वर्ड्स आएंगे हिस्ट्री में पढ़ते समय इस चैप्टर में. नाउ we have to talk about another's. Let's read and make you understand clearly. So this chapter traces the history, the beginning of human existence. Okay, human existence ke baare mein padhenge. It was 5.6 million years ago, correct? Million years ago will be written as MYA, correct? So that the first human life creatures appeared on the earth's surface. After this, several forms of humans emerged and then became extinct. Yani alag alag insano ke roop aaye aur wo khatam hote chale gaye. To hum in roopon ki baat karenge ki unhone kaun kaun se roop liye. जिसमें से मैंने अभी आपको बताया पायरामिड्स, PRIMATS, पायरामिड्स. सेकेंड था होमिनाइड्स, ठीक है. अब हम बात करेंगे इन ग्रुप्स को चैप्टर्स में. सो ह्यूमन बीइंग रिसेम्बलिंग अस ओरिजिनेटेड अबाउट 160,000 इयर्स एगो, करेक्टली. आई जस्ट टोल्ड यू जिसमें मैं बात कर रही थी मॉडर्न मैन. मॉडर्न मैन का जो रूप आया है अराउंड 1,60,000 million ईयर्स एगो वी गॉट इट. तो ड्यूरिंग दिस लॉन्ग पीरियड ऑफ ह्यूमन हिस्ट्री पीपल ऑब्टेन फूड बाय ईदर स्क्रैवेंजिंग और ह्यूमन हंटिंग एंड गैदरिंग प्लांट प्रोडक्ट्स, करेक्ट. तो अर्ली ह्यूमंस जब आए तो उन्होंने रहना, खाना और एक जगह पे बसना कैसे शुरू किया, ये पूरा हिस्ट्री ह्यूमन हिस्ट्री पर डिपेंड करता है और उस पूरे पीरियड को कहते हैं स्टोन एज. सो दे आल्सो लर्न हाउ टू मेक स्टोन टूल्स एंड टू कम्युनिकेट विद ईच अदर. सो दिस पीरियड विच विल बी अराउंड 6,000 अराउंड मिलियंस ऑफ इयर्स एगो to 1,60,000 millions ago, years ago, they will be giving us the history of human life who has changed his life from scavenging to the hunter-gatherers, and later they have shifted as a producers, correct. So all the other ways of obtaining food were adopted later. जिसमें हम एग्रीकल्चर की बात करेंगे तो दैट वाज कंसीडर्ड एज अ लेटर ऑन. यानी पहले वो स्ट्रगलर थे, हंटर थे, उसके बाद में वो सेटलर हो गए, यानी एक जगह पे बस गए. तो उन्होंने फूड को ऑब्टेन करना धरती से शुरू कर दिया. हंटिंग गैदरिंग कंटिन्यू इवन टुडे. देयर आर हंटर गैदरर सोसाइटी इन सम पार्ट्स ऑफ द वर्ल्ड. This make us wonder whether the lifestyle of present day hunter gatherers can tell us anything about the past. Might be. I am not sure about this. Correct. So I will be giving you this information on your SNAP homework also. Please update yourself with the SNAP app. So जब हम history पढ़ते हैं तो we have to clear with the two terms. First one is the fossils. Fossils kya hote hain? Fossils are the remains or impressions of a very old plant, animal or human which have turned into stone, correct. And these are often embedded in rocks and are thus preserved for millions of years. I'll show you in next picture we are having related to this. Yes, you can see shows how fossil fragment is recovered from the surrounding stone. In this case, a variety of limestone in which it is embedded. As you can see, this required skill and patience. ठीक है. सो दिस यू कैन सी वी आर हैविंग अ पिक्चर विच इज शोइंग यू अ स्कल ऑन दिस, दैट इज अ फॉसिल. Okay, another we are having side, we are having this one, you can see shows the equipment used for recording the locations of finds. The square frame to the left of the archaeologist is the grid divided into 10 centimeter squares. Placing it over the find spot helps to recover the horizontal position of the find. So the triangular apertures to the right is used to recover the vertical position. So that is the archaeologist. They move to the sites and they try to recover the fossils. Okay, in this they the archaeologist try to recover these fossils, and they try to preserve it for the millions of years, that these are the sources of a history. Okay, so that will give you more clear picture of the history when we are clear with the concepts. Our next word is species. These are some of the basic terms we always use in science and SST. So species is a group of organism that can breed to produce fertile offspring. Members of one species cannot mate with those of other species to produce fertile offsprings. Correct. So species will be of the same, will be from the same what you will say एक ही तरीके की चलती आती है, वो कभी दूसरे स्पीशीज से मिक्स नहीं हो सकती है. ठीक है, तो यहाँ पे हम बात करेंगे स्पीशीज की भी. सो एनसीईआरटी बुक विच विल बी कलर्ड वन, दिस वन इज द ब्लू वन, दैट विल बी गिविंग अस द सोर्स. सो जो हमें हेल्प करते टू अंडरस्टैंड द अर्ली ह्यूमन history. Okay, so these two words we will be having a detailed understanding in this column also. So first I have talked about the fossils, then was the species. Okay, so the discoveries of human fossils means discoveries of the human fossils, stone tools and cave paintings help us to understand early human history. Okay, if we are going to understand the human history, we have to understand about DC. We have to survey on human fossils, stone tools and cave paintings, especially for the early histories, means ancient one, which we are not having much evidences. So early of these discoveries had a history of its own. Very often when such finds were first made, most scholars refused to accept that these fossils were the remains of early humans. They were also skeptical about the ability of early humans to make the stone tools and paint. It was only over a period of time that the true significance of these finds was realized. Correct. So the evidence of human evolution comes from fossils of species of humans which have become extinct. Fossils can be dated either through direct chemical analysis or indirect by dating the segments in which they are buried. Once fossils are dated, a sequence of human evolution can be worked out. So one such discovery was made around 200 years ago when scholars were often reluctant to accept that fossils and other findings include stone tools and paintings, which were actually connected with the early forms of humans. So we can see many stone tools have been found. Many paintings have been recovered from these sites. So this reliquant generally seen from their belief in the Old Testament of the Bible. This is very important. You know, most scholars refuse to accept that these objects were the remains of early humans. They did not believe the ability of the human man to make stone tools or paints. Okay, so what? Because according to the Old Testament of Bible, human origin was an act of creation by God. Correct. So after a few years, the true significance of these findings were realized. Next, we are having more evidences related to this. In August 1856, workmen who were quarrying of limestone in the Netherland Valley, a gorge near a German city of Drispol, found a skull and some skeleton fragment. I'll show you where we are talking about. We are talking about this skull. This the skull of Netherland man. Some of those who dismiss the antiquity of the skull regarding it as British or that of the pathological idols. Okay, ideas. You know what happens when we find this type of evidences from any of the places? We give that name of that place with the person name who recovered that. So this was named as a Nether Valley, a gorge near the German city. Okay, these were handed to the cult Freiholt, a local schoolmaster and a natural historian, who realized that this skull represented a form of human that was extinct. At the time, scholars did not accept this view and instead declared that the skull belonged to a person of more recent times. But later, they accepted it and named as Netherland men. Okay, have you understand? Jahan pe milta hai, most of the name usi places pe chala jata hai. So we are having a very famous person, Charles Darwin. His book is On the Origin of Species. He has written and got the book published in on 24th November 1859. Okay, and he got the copies around 1250, which is sold in the same day. Okay, it was this book will give us lots of evidences and the stories related to the early humans. Correct. So I'm going to wind up the topic here. Our next topics are more interesting. We are going to start the story of human evaluations. Okay, students, take rest and make notes of these topics also. Thank you and have a nice day.